Hello, YouTube! I am Penstar, and this is Hearthlands Strategy and Tactics Episode 7. So in our last episode, we kicked some butt. We took some names, namely leveling the local graveyard over here. And while we were feeling our oats, went over here and did likewise to the Warlock's Tower. Now we still have this active graveyard here, but we know we can take out a graveyard. It's just a matter of dedicating the resources and guys to it. Right then, as far as expanding our economy, I've noticed that we are up to, we still have extra room for 664, so we don't need to be in a super high hurry to grow our houses any larger than they are right now, because there's still tons of freaking room in the ones we already have. Now people will just slowly continue to migrate. How is our reputation? Excellent. All right. So we've moved in the last 12 months. We're still getting tons of people. A few people have died, unfortunately. 76 have moved out. I'm not sure. Well, probably from a few houses shrinking, but that's okay. That's okay. We're in a good place right now. So I think we've got about 108 people left to employ here, and I think I know what I want to employ, because our coin reserves, well, holding steady-ish is kind of on the decline. So I want to address that, and I want to address that more directly. Now, one of the things that the Southerners can do, I think there's one of the other cultures that can do this, is they can mint coins. If you take one unit of gold and one unit of coal, it will make you money, which goes directly into your coffers. Like, you don't have to find a buyer for it. You just mint more currency. And apparently they haven't invented inflation yet. So, Now, if we want to get into this gold reserve, which happens to be next to a nice coal reserve, that's probably going to cheese these skeletons off. But like I said before, we know we can take them. So, you know what? Let's start this episode off with a little bit of a bang. Although our archers are a little bit anemic. What I might actually end up doing here is, if the turd monsters spawn, I hate to use the Phantom Warriors to fight turd monsters. It just does not seem right. I think I might just use one unit of archers here, the smaller of the units, plus my horsemen, plus one of these guys, as my skeleton buster. And if they need reinforcements, then I'll call upon them. You guys go here. And I will need to be paying close attention to orders. Yes, my lord. Actually, if I put them in the middle, I wonder if they'll actually aggro onto these guys. I want them to be available too, because I forget which of the two. Yeah, with this military upkeep starting to nibble away at me, we're going to want to make sure that we keep things nice and sound here. And like I said, I don't feel comfortable building out my gold thing until we take these skeletons out.
Your Majesty.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, Your Majesty.
Oh, for Pete's sake. All right, folks. Guys ready? We're going to try and take out the defenders before any of them hit. And we want all the skeletons to aggro onto them. That is exactly the opposite of what I wanted them to do.
Yes. Your Majesty, your glory.
Get your butts over here and tank. No, don't pop the... because then they're going to spawn more skeletons. But at least I got some of them over here, so they're not slaughtering all of our archers. All right, get up there. And of course you're all gonna, and that way when you hit it again, it might spawn more. No, it didn't. Okay, good. Oh, nope, it did. Distracted by the goblin. Yes, please have all the horsemen. Why are you jockeying for position here? This is not a horse race. Oh boy, struck down. All right, good, the archers are on them, but they're not tanking them. All right, so that last one was from up there. All right, which means you guys can go up here. And once again, it's like, okay, it's a done deal. Yeah, with our much more numerous horsemen here, we're in a good place in terms of military power. I'm trying to prevent deaths as much as possible here.
I'm here, my lord.
Curious to see what I'm gonna go back to having my two archer squads just be the ones sitting there. And then my much more powerful horseman can do some exploration or spot attacking if necessary. And we get some fame out of the deal. Alright. So you guys are down there. You guys go back there. And you horsemen. You know what? I think I'm going to just stop the goblins. Just park the horsemen there and have them on goblin murdering duty. That way they don't even come near me. Alright, we've got a lot of resources here. We've got some lore to spend, we've got some magic to spend. And how are we doing? Yeah, see, we've got some unemployment. We've got less unemployment now, because some of our people have died. So you know what? I think I'm going to take my rank 2 of diligence here. As expensive as it is, getting all those workers up is going to be worth it. And we have a butt ton more. I'm not going to get rank 3 anytime soon. Bureaucracy, more taxes, theology. Yes, we want theology. Kaboom. I wouldn't mind being bureaucracy. Logistics is another one, but let's try some of these. Customs, we can get more out of our trade routes. That might be a good one, given how much trading we do. Patronage. We could take persuasion, bluff. But the other thing I might want to grab, well, you know what, I'm going to hold on to it, because there's nothing else that I need immediately. Except maybe archery. But I need more science for that. Now, magic. What else can we do here? We've got our Phantom Warriors, but there's still a lot more that we can do. Could pick up Bountiful Harvest. We could Bountiful Harvest our freaking cotton and have a cotton explosion. That's not a bad idea. Midas Touch. We got pretty efficient tax collectors. You know what? I'm going to take Bountiful Harvest, though. And once all of our cotton here grows, we're going to be in good shape. You know what? These guys are fighting with each other. These guys were farting around, helping them plant and pick their stuff. They didn't get any of their own cotton in the ground. That's a problem. That's a problem right there. I'm going to move them. I'm not going to dismantle them now, but I'm going to move them, because that is problematic. But we have more people now, so let us dive into this. Let us actually physically make money. So the ratio that we're looking at here is each coal digger gives you 12 loads per year. We're going to get 2 of those. Same goes with the gold digger, 12 loads per year, 1 and 2. And we then combine them into a mint, which can handle, essentially, it handles 24, like most manufacturing. So two of one, two of the other will keep this thing busy. And that's all I really need. And you don't even need to put it near down here, because again, as soon as it makes the coins, it appears right here. I don't need to take it to anything. So that, my friends, will be a source of cash money. Literally cash money in the bank. Now, as far as our fame goes, because we also have a butt ton of fame, Stutrath does not like us. I do not, I don't like that their merchant was killed. That's what set them off. Let's improve those relations. Yeah, so that's one way to really piss them off, is to have their merchants die in our lands. We're going to have to smooth some ruffled feathers. Drumberry, we're going to... Yeah, we don't want anybody in the negatives with us. Innerst. Yeah, we got to smooth that over. We do not want any negatives. No negative Nancys, please. All right, I think what I'll do is I will move our cotton production way over here to get the heck away from here. Or actually, I might move it way the heck down here. Move all my cotton farms down here. Why not? Unemployment is low, tax level is high. We are fully staffed here, good. Killing spree, oh yeah, the turd monsters. Yeah, look, they took down a whole lot of merchants. So it is alcohol? We're running low on alcohol? Oh my. Well, one thing we can do to prevent that is if we set all of these to 16, what's going to happen is we're going to stockpile 16 units of alcohol for personal use before any of them gets used, gets traded away. Yeah. Can't believe they shorted our crop this badly, because they were fighting over this. I didn't heed my own advice. They were far too close. So we're gonna have a pretty lousy cotton crop. All right, but we should be getting our coins coming in pretty nicely here. Coins minted, nothing yet, but it's working. Oh, cheese trade route, eh? All right, good. Our unemployment is going back up. Not normally something you'd hear a leader say, but... Oh, thank goodness. Can only hold 7, huh? Oh, we'll take the 7. You guys all need clothing. What is this madness? I think we might need another storage yard here. Oop, not there. Hang on. That's not going to be any good. Needs to touch both top and bottom here. All right, well, hang on. Since we don't really need this watchtower anymore. This one right here. There, we can squeeze one more of these bad boys in here. So yeah, since we're doing the 16 wine thing, we need more storage space. But we will still accept everything that we need to accept. We just don't want to load up with too many goods here. We have 16. Yeah, take them. Go ahead. Off you go. Again, friendly neighbors, please, friendly neighbors. We are short on clothing. Let us remedy that with some buying power. Kingham, help us out. And we are going to also need to replace that in the longer term or shorter term. Extra weaver's shop. Extra clothier's shop. This time we actually need the extra clothier's shop. There we go. Excellent. And yeah, they're just murdering goblins as they come, so we don't have to worry about them anymore. Hey, if I'm paying for them, I might as well. All right. Now let me remind myself, now that all this frickin' cotton is, almost all of the cotton is harvested, it looks like they finally got to the end of it here. Well, you know what? Yeah, I'm going to put all the cotton fields here. We're going to double the number of cotton fields because we're going to get into pillows. We need more clothing. We need a lot of cotton. Metric F-ton of cotton. With 131 people free? Heck yeah. And actually, hang on, let me just try change something here. Checks. So if we put the cotton all the way up here, they're not going to touch. We could turn these into just grain fields. Well, nah. We'll do something else with them. Off you go. Alright, we're going to get, we're going to double them. Actually, if we got three things of clothing, we're going to need three lines of pillows. So that means we're going to need six of these plus the accompanying cotton fields. This is going to be kind of crazy, but I'll take it. 2... Three. I'll get some roads going here. We're just gonna loop-de-loop these around here, and I'm just gonna make a big F-ton of cotton fields. And if they need more, I'll give them more. I'm not gonna do all the math. But if they need more fields, we'll give them more fields. Oh yeah, I might also need... Well, I'm going to keep that storage there, but they're going to need more storage. No doubts about it. You, my friend, are going to be all cotton all the time. And then once this cotton starts producing itself, I will get down a whole butt-ton more pillow makers, and we will get our people pillows as they so desire, the last of the luxury goods. So the houses may get to there. Because, yeah, we're starting to fill up the houses that we have. Holy crap, we're still at 101 people? Man, what else am I going to build? Well, with more of those, we're going to need more of the basics. How are we on food? We are... Oh, those are the pillows, right. We are actually, well, I wouldn't say running out of food. All right, hang on. We got excess boots. We can stop buying boots. We've got excess furniture. We can stop buying furniture. We need to buy the clothes. We can stop... Well, actually, no. I'm glad we're buying the freaking cotton because of the huge derp from before. We want to keep buying into that cotton. Grain. No, we're not selling grain. We're already buying grain. We can sell cotton, but again, not worth it. Coal and iron. And furniture. We could sell furniture. Well, you know what? Why not sell some furniture? And then just get into another round of making more furniture, too. Because I anticipate there's going to be more demand. Here's what we're going to do. We're actually going to stick a forester's lodge out here. Or rather, a woodcutter's lodge out here. To get into this forester's lodge and the surrounding. And you know what? We'll get a forester's lodge here. No mushrooms, please. Yeah, we had some housing shrinkages here, thanks to the clothing situation, but I think we'll be okay. Oh, we're in planting season? I might get those two extra grain fields. I might go for that. Maybe not over there, but, well... Again, we just don't want them to touch the... Yeah, we'll take that. We'll turn on transparency. Actually, we don't need to cut down anything down here. It looks like we do, but we don't. Well, we do. We need to cut down one tree. There, that will help that out. So we'll be getting more grain in. We can then get another round of our windmills and bakeries here, so we can step up our food production. Because I have a feeling that's going to be our next bottleneck. Oh, and more alcohol. We need to make more alcohol. How are we on? 82. You know what? Alcohol, ho! Alcohol. You know what? This is all going to be clothing and pillow stuff, so that is what I am determining. Let's just get another ridge up here. And make it, more booze. Yeah, because these things plant June. We're right around the corner from that. So we might as well. Oh, what the hey? Let's go for broke. Let's go for drunk. All the wine. 11 billion wine. This will give us more than enough alcohol for ourselves and plenty to trade to our friends and enemies, who have then become our friends because we're giving them booze. Yeah, I think we're good here, so let's unpause. Oops. How are we doing with workers? Holy crap! Oh, you know what it is? The tax level goes down. So we're gonna get less in taxes, but that entices more people to work. The game can automatically adjust that for you. And yes, we're getting more clothing in here. That is desperately needed. Why are we not, did our pillows route close? Because why are we storing pillows? Why are we storing pillows? Our pillows route closed. That's why we're storing pillows. Well, I don't want to distribute them, because then they're going to level up, and then we're going to run short on pillows. Well, maybe if I only allow one of these guys to pick up pillows. That'll free up some space. Ah, it stinks that we ran out of that. And it's still at 10% unemployment here. Yeah, these guys leveled down pretty hard because of lack of clothing. All right, good. We're getting it going here. And yep, there's our delivery of pillows. So they're going to be leveling up. And the final level, level 10 to 11, is one last check for surroundings. It needs to be really freaking beautiful, and it is. So we're going to have ourselves some top level houses here pretty soon. Once we get more of our pillow makers going, and once we get all these fields going, I'll cast my harvest blessing on them so we can get metric F tons of cotton. Probably enough to sell. Whoa, 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 whoa. Who got struck down? You guys are slow on the ball there. And sheesh, our horse finally gone here. All right, one more from that. We are running low on coins, though. Our trade profit is still draining us. We need to fix some of that. I'm okay buying the grain. I'm okay buying the logs. The cotton is not going to be needed to be bought anymore. Clothing is still needed because we still have shortages. We are selling eggs. We're selling worse. Oh, you know what it is? We're stockpiling the freaking wine. But pretty soon, I don't think that's going to be a problem. That's not going to be a problem at all. Got food. Got plenty of those. And how is our minting? 3,200. Not too shabby. I'm okay letting these be a slow burn. I'm not going to go crazy with them because eventually they will run out. Oh, the other reason I want to keep my horsemen here is when you go digging in above ground stuff, there's a chance for elementals to spawn. And that's something that you need your military to intervene in. So our horsemen will be there to tank, and then we'll be able to draw one of our archer platoons off there as well. Who else is buying stuff? We still need more money. I don't want to sell grain. I'm certainly sure as hell not selling furniture. Hell no! Ooh, but I can... Well, I could sell planks. Could sell more feathers. Are we building up feathers? I don't think so. I don't think we're building up feathers. Pretty soon I might have to be selling off grain, though. Did you seriously take that all the way over there? Oi. Alright, tax level is medium. Going tall. Boom! And we're still short on clothes. Once we get our burst of cotton in, though, we'll be in business. And I'll be able to turn... Okay, you guys are finally all... Finally all getting into this. You're finally all starting to plant. Now, one thing I need to check here. Doubles the next cross harvest in the radius of the spell.
Ready to serve.
Well, I could have... That's about as good as I'm going to get. Hopefully that just sticks around, even though they haven't planted that yet. So we'll see how much in the way of cotton we get out of that beast. I mean, I could do it to grain, but I have a feeling that's just going to completely decimate us and choke us with grain. Alright, we actually have some clothing piling up. I'm going to let it pile up a little bit so we don't run into more shortages. Oh, and you need more prettiness. You need additional prettiness. I can assist you with that. If we put you there? Nope. How about there? Nope.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, Your Majesty.
Are you kidding me? Oh, that's it? Well, it looks like I'm going to need another regiment of archers. Keep babysitting these things. Although they're still refilling there. I could do another regiment of horses. I might need to. Oh, I don't have the stone. Well, one thing we can do, especially with our economics here, let's get mining so that we... Well, we need now lumber. Do we have enough lumber to build that? Let's find out. Quarry. Yes, we do have enough lumber. Excellent. Well, this thing over here is our resident stone getter, or stone stockpile. No need for another one. So we'll build our quarry right here and just let it slowly accumulate stone for us. No need to go buying it. And then once we get enough stone, we'll build another horse regiment. How are we on workers now? Still good. In hindsight, I should have put these on the outside and had this all in a big sphere. I have a feeling that's not going to be able to handle this. All right, folks. Oh, man, this is still not quite pretty enough, huh? There you go. Now it's pretty enough for you. Ah, crap. And the turd monsters have emerged. Horsemen!
Majesty.
Babysit the turd monsters. We'll get another thing of archers soon enough. Yeah, I mean, they're not chowing down on everybody, but they're close enough that they could prey on my woodcutters, and that's no fun.
I'm here, my lord.
Oh yeah, we got those extra things. Let's get one more extra sawmill to get the extra grains. God, look at all this line! Look at all this wine! Oh man, this is going to be madness. Absolute madness. You know what? I'm going to turn off the need to hold on to 16 things of wine. Just trade it all. We'll have enough. Look at all this. All this untapped potential that is now being tapped hard. So, if you like this episode and you want to see more like it, go ahead and hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and leave me a comment, good, bad, or indifferent. Your feedback's always welcome. So until next time, this has been Pinstar, signing out. See ya!